Good morning, students. Today you'll discuss about the derivation of expression for kinetic energy. On our previous lecture, we have discussed that the amount of a moving object can do work means the amount of work done that a moving object can do before coming to rest is equal to its kinetic energy. We have also develop the concept by some examples. For example, a bullet fired from a gun can penetrate a target due to its kinetic energy. The kinetic energy of air is used to run windmills. The kinetic energy of a fast stream of water is used to run water mills. So now discuss here. We have a body of mass M moving with initial velocity A, and the body, when we apply a constant force, remember in all of our discussion we have assumed that the force acting on the body remains constant throughout the motion. So it is moving with initial velocity U. After applying the force, it displaces to a distance S, and its velocity changes because the work done on the object will cause the change in velocity, and its velocity is V. So due to change in velocity, acceleration will be there, and the acceleration will be A. So you can apply the equation of motion V square minus U square is equal to 2As. So S is equal to V square minus U square upon 2A. Now, as you know that the force on displacement are here in the same direction, which is a case of positive work. In this case, the work is equal to force into displacement. And in place of if you write MAS. Now, if you putting the value of this S from equation 1A, if you put here this work done is equal to MA V square minus U square upon 2A. So ultimately you will find W is equal to half M V square minus U square, or you can write half M V square minus U square. It means this work done appears as kinetic energy. So kinetic energy is, so the we can write here the work done is equal to half M V square minus U. So this is known as work energy. This is known as work energy theorem. Means if this work done by the object, work done by the force, is equal to the change in kinetic energy. So the work energy principle is not independent of the Newton's second law. And remember this work energy principle: if the body moves with initial velocity u, then this will be half mv square minus half mu square. But if the body is initially at rest, means u is equal to zero, then this kinetic energy will be equal to half mv square. And this is the required expression for the kinetic energy. So now see here, we can conclude here. When a particle or object moves in a circle with constant speed, then the kinetic energy of an object remains same at every point. Means according to work energy theorem, work done on the body is zero. So we can conclude that when kinetic energy increases, the work done is positive, and when the kinetic energy decreases, the work done is negative. So this will help you in solving the numericals. But if it is asked to derive an expression for kinetic energy, so initially you can consider U is equal to zero, and you will derive directly from here kinetic energy is equal to half mv square. So this is the required expression for the kinetic energy, that is equal to half mv square. You can write the formula in terms of, you can represent kinetic energy in terms of momentum, multiplying by m, you'll find here half m in numerator and denominator by m. So this is half m square v square, and you know that the mv is equal to p. So this is kinetic energy equal to p square upon 2m, or p is equal to kinetic energy is equal to p square upon 2m, or p is equal to root over 2mk. So this formula is very important. You'll discuss it in detail while taking live classes, how this kinetic energy will depend when the momentum will same, two bodies having same momentum, and what will the effect on this kinetic momentum when the kinetic energy is increased or decreased. So we'll discuss in live classes. So now the another point, this is very important, that the work energy theorems holds good in all cases, and we will not include another type of forces. So thank you very much. You will discuss the potential energy in the next point. Thank you.